Hi everyone, welcome to Motivation Corner. This is Mbulugeng, your favorite host, your favorite podcaster with Bank. Thank you so much for watching, for viewing my contact, not only with Bank. Thank you, world, for continuously coming to my channel. I'm just here to welcome the first time people. If you are here for the first time, you just click this video by mistake. Please stay. You're not gonna regret it. Thank you for being here. Firstly, watch. After watching, please like the video if you like the content. And please share with your friends, your family. After that, please subscribe. And let me clear this out, because there were people who were asking me how to subscribe. There is something written subscribe there. You need to click that thing and subscribe. And it's it doesn't cost anything. It's free. It's free of charge. There's no money that you'll have to pay every month and say because you have subscribed to this channel. No, it's just to add my audience and people that we can account for. So please subscribe. Please like. It's very, very important that the video is liked. And okay, and then also those who've been coming here, the returnees, if you last video you watched and then you came back again, thank you for coming. If you've been here since way back, thank you for coming back. And please comment down below and say, I'm a returnee, and I will welcome you next time. I'll say your name. Thank you for being here, for coming back. I really, really appreciate it. So guys, we started like posting videos in February. It's been like 4 months of great joy, great learning. We have grown so much. I hope you as a viewer, you've also grown, because wow, guys, the conversations that I've been having with the people that I invited, guys, they're out of this world. And I always told people that everybody has a story. Every person has a story, but I wanted us to get inspired, influenced by people that we can see as people of Witbank, people that are so not known to the world or to the whole of South Africa, but people that are close by, that we know and can see what they are doing and learn from them. So thank you so much to my guests that came, and their bravery in sharing their lives, because these days we all know that social media is very rife. It's very cruel. Sometimes people can misunderstand you and twist your words. But thank you so much, regardless of that, for saying, I'm going to come and share my story and inspire one person. And guys, I think we have reached the views of always, the views that we would get is an average of plus minus 150 views. Guys, that is a lot. And I'm grateful for that. Like, the word of God says we must be grateful for each and everything. Even there's this song, so thank you so much for the views. I just post and I just advertise on my Facebook, on my Instagram, on my WhatsApp, and there's views coming. So thank you so much to everybody who takes their time to watch. Yes, like as I said, that it has been great 4 months, and we shall call it first season of Motivation Corner with my guests and some of the videos where I was taking them alone. So I'm just going to wrap up every video, like just recap and just say what I take out of that. And I've asked some of the people what they took from some of the videos. So I'm just going to share that and some of the testimonies that I got from these videos, from these guests. So guys, a lot has been happening. If you haven't watched most of the videos, please go back, make yourself a favor. Like, Yaki Pride, like, just go, click. You never know. Maybe you've been struggling with something and that one click with someone's story can help your life. So guys, before wasting a lot of time, let me go to the first video of my guest. I invited the Mbatas, Usiza and Standile. Those are my friends. And I asked them to come and talk about their love or their marriage.
For 7 years, but how long have you known each other? How long have you been in a relationship? Okay, so we've known each other for, this is going to be our 10th year. We've known each other for 10 years because we started dating in 2014. Oh. Yes, so we've been together for 10 years and then married for 7 years.
Go on. Actually, to come in there, we actually met on this exact day in 2014.
Guys! Okay.
He's
very good with days.
What's the day today?
It's the...
Okay, yeah. So I didn't know whether to say the date, but yeah, we actually met on the 27th of January, 2014.
Okay. I've always looked at them since she's my friend, from when they were dating, from to now when they are married and their parents. Their love story always inspired me. And I was like, my friend, your story is worth telling. And I hope someone who watched it believes in love because of what they have shared. But what I take from myself out of that and what I think maybe it's working for them, we can say when they said for them to work, they allow each other to be themselves and they don't like force each other into each other's world. Yes, they are a team, but they still allow individuality, because most of the time when people are married, it's either someone is not allowed to be the adventurous person that they are, or the person who's indoors, the other person will always complain like, this one is forever in the house, or no, this one likes to gallivant. But they find time to be together, and also when they have to go their separate ways, they do that with knowing that they are still together. So I take that for myself. And then we are done with Cesar, and I hope you have something. If you watched that video, comment down below what you took out of that video. And let's talk about the second guest that I called. It was Vanessa Bizzi. That video has the most views. It has over 500 views. I don't know what the girl has, but it must be her. Vanessa, your video is the highlight of the season one of Motivation Corner. So thank you for watching. I think maybe it's because you are youth or whatever, but your video did great, and I'm so grateful for people who kept on watching and who were mostly inspired. I saw a lot of comments. There was like a lot of interaction. To this day, I still wonder what did we do right there so that we can repeat on other videos. But at some point you have information. So this week, guys, I thought, I mean, we've seen Abo Zozi, we've seen Abo Rolling Straws. So today I was like, as weed bankers, I know this beautiful, beautiful girl, and she's going to introduce herself. Then I thought she should come and we talk about beauty with brains and pageantry, this whole miss thing. And yeah, thank you so much. Please welcome yourself.
Thank you so much for having me today. Hi everyone, I am Vanessa Bizzi, Miss Inspire South Africa 2023. I am a founder of Bokamoso Foundation, and I'm also a master's student in the Faculty of Management.
What is your community work and what do you advocate for?
I advocate for equal opportunities and education.
Okay.
I think one's education is not supposed to be determined by your welfare gibo, their skin tone, or their background. Everybody should get access to, you know, quality education. Because
yeah.
When I do my community outreach, I see goodie. It's not a matter of the uniform as well. The classes that are not proper.
To standard.
Yes, they're packed. They maybe about 40 learners in the same class. How so? And being that kid, when you go back home, you're in class, you're thinking, Guti, what am I going to eat? Mangfie kaya. And
what I took from Vanessa, it was when I was asking her, how does she balance being a student and beauty pageants? And she said something that doesn't go out of my mind. She said she doesn't procrastinate. She's not a procrastinator. If she's given work today, which is due in 2 weeks' time, she will do it today to avoid working under pressure. And as a student, whoever you are, you might be working, also a student, also a parent. If you have time, do it on time. Like, immediately they give you, just find time to do it. Let's stop this thing of doing things under pressure, because you end up not producing quality. So guys, I hope you took something out of it. I took that for myself. The third guest, it was Undumi.
We don't understand how to eat. We don't understand the process of digestion. Remember, it starts from chewing. So we don't even chew enough. So we chew chunks. We swallow chunks of food. It did not, like, we did not go to 3-5 rounds, but at least that first round was perfect. Like, you'll be admitted just because you are full of toxins, you are full of shit, you are full of poop, you are full of waste. You'll be admitted in the hospital and they will do what?
We're talking about colon health. So, guys, the calls that I got from people wanting to book to get their colon cleansed, yo, it's so remarkable. Even now, like, there's still people who are like, yo, Ruth, oh, Bulugang, I've seen your video with that lady. Can you please give us the number? We want to book ourselves for colon health. So, Ndumi, shout out to you, girl, and how you explain it. The passion you have about your job. Yo, it's so inspiring for me as an aspiring businesswoman. It's so inspiring. And also, it shows that you know your product from in and out. But what I took from the video is that, from the conversation, is that every problem, every sickness that we have, it starts from our gut health. So if we can take care of our gut, if we can take care of our colon, most of the sicknesses that we have, they will be, like, it will be healed, because we just need to poop, guys. We just need to let waste out of our system. So, guys, if you haven't watched that video, I really urge you to go watch the video of Ndumi talking about colon health. Guys, you won't regret it. There's testimonies. Even if you go to her pages, go to her, she will tell you of so many great testimonies. But the other thing that I took there, I had to learn that sometimes we don't have bad breath. Even though you can brush your teeth and what, it's not because our dental hygiene is poor, but sometimes it's because we are full of poop. So we need to go get our colon cleansed so that we are confident we can breathe like other kids, you know? So guys, please watch that video. I love it. And you will get it. You will get so much out of it. And then we invited Brian. The video didn't do well. I don't know where the mistake is. If you can go back and watch it, please go comment how can we improve. Because I've seen that after colon cleansing, obviously you will have to keep a healthy lifestyle. So I thought, let me get someone who's going to motivate us that we can exercise, having a healthy lifestyle. But out of that video, what I took is that there's no age for exercise. Every person needs to take care of their health. A little bit of exercise, even if you don't go to the gym, just take a walk, have a certain target for your steps that you need to take, have your body movement so one way or the other. It's very important for your health, for your physical health, and it's also important for your mental health and your emotional well-being. So guys, let's exercise and let's do the right thing. Because I want to ask, like, for people who are not at gym but they would love to try gym and shape up their body, how should they start? They start by running, like, or it depends on your goals. Some people don't even have a goal, but they just want to start exercising. What do we say to such people?
Okay, what I can say to people is that fitness or gym is not about going to the gym, like direct being in the gym, environment of a gym, structure. Fitness about, you can start working out at home. Understand? You can start working out, depending on your goal, if you want to run, we can say you can run on the road. You can have time frame where you can run. You want to start lifting or mini cardio exercises, you can do it at home. It's all about having the equipment or knowing what you want. Yeah, so that's how I can say to people, it's not about seeing those people at the gym posting and be like, hey, I want to start gym, but don't have money to pay. But at home, at your garage, at your garden.
other video which I inspired me like so much, it was the video with Vuyokazi Makunga, where what inspired me on that video, it was her saying at the age of 30 she started a new career. Because yes, when I met her, she was a chemical analyst at Anglo, so now she's a psychometrist and a psychologist. So I was like, how did she even do it? But I just saw that, I just learned that time moves and it's fast. 3 years is nothing. If you can start something now, in 3 years you'll be done. Like if you started in January, look, now we are halfway the year. And you're going to be done. Next year, it's second year, you are left with just a year and then you are done. So guys, also there's no age limit to career changes, Yeah, so guys, if you've been wanting to do something and you are working and try to do something, it's your life. No one rules you. You have every right to start whatever you want to do. It's your life. You understand? So I'm inspired. I want to be a biggest podcaster. I was more inspired to keep going on, and I'm thinking I'm going to enroll some of the classes just so that I get better into this, how to ask questions, how to be a better presenter, how to be a better host, so that my dream comes to pass, and how to be a great motivator, because I aspire to be a motivational speaker. So I'm in my late 30s, but I know I'm not yet late. Anything is possible at any age. So guys, I hope you're inspired.
In 2014, I was 30 then. And I was like, should I start something new? Should I not? I'm too old. I ended up starting. I did a degree in psychology. Any struggle that a child is having at school, that's where I get it.
Had another conversation with this beautiful woman, Tina Mananyezo, a triathlete. So, yo, the conversation with that lady, I'm sorry that the video had problem with the audio. There was nothing we can do. We tried our best to work on the audio, but it didn't. But you can still hear what she's saying. But if you can watch it, you will learn a lot of things. Like she's that person, eh? When you're watching her, or if you follow her, you'll see that she's a go-getter. She goes for what she wants. She's not limited by anything. So guys, what I took out of that video, it was when she told me that at her 35th birthday, she booked herself a guest house and told herself that I'm going to have time with God, where I'm going to talk to God about myself. Yes, I've been speaking to a psychologist, speaking to pastors, speaking to all these people, but they couldn't tell me who I am. So she was like, this time I'm making sure that I'm going to talk to my creator who will tell me who I am. So guys, I was like, yo, it takes guts and faith. It says a lot about her faith that you were like, I'm just going to have a conversation and I'm going to trust what the Lord say and act on that. So she does a lot of things. She crochet, she has businesses, she's a sportswoman. She's doing it all and effortlessly. So guys, please go back to that video and watch and be inspired.
Because of the background, because of the past and whatnot. So for me to start this business, it was not easy because I was not trusting myself, but I had skills. But then I had to do it. I said, I'll see it when I get there. So now it's so funny that I don't do the work anymore. And people does the job. But then I'm the...
You know, if I can be honest, the reason I was like, I've always liked this podcasting thing, and then, you know, life happened and I was like, now lazy. But seeing your statuses, how one day you like, I'm selling activewear, the other time you're running, I knew you as a marathon runner, then the next thing you're doing cycling, like I had to teach myself. Like I was like, looking, do what you need to do. And I was like, I sat down with myself, it is your influence, I don't know, maybe like really, because I was like, I love this. And I really didn't go to school to study journalism so that I can ask the question or be good at talking. But I always felt like I need to put information. I'm passionate about people's well-being. And for me, the best way is to have a podcast like this. And I was like, I need to go back. And I was like, I'm going back. I'm not perfect, but I'll be perfect as time goes on. It's because of seeing you, how you always go for you like even early January, because I was still thinking, I was like, you went to China for the first time by yourself. Yes, the third last conversation that we had, it was with Yvette Shibambo. Guys, what a powerhouse. She's a senior manager at Eskom. So you can imagine the conversation. She's in her 50s. So you can imagine the amount of experience there, the amount of life lessons, the nuggets that you can get out of that conversation. So guys, please go watch that video. It's a two-part video. And yo, I don't even know. I don't... Like, I have a lot of lessons out of that, but I can only highlight once, because I want you to go and watch the other the whole conversation and be inspired. Maybe I'm not even saying it the right way. Just go and hear it for yourself. So on that conversation, what stood out for me, she's a senior manager at Eskom. So she's driving this small car. And I was like, how? Well, not for a manager driving this car. It's like, no, it's... When you are my age and at the position that I am, I've done it all. She has done it all. She has done the mistakes of buying expensive cars, of not saving enough. And she found herself in a difficult place sometimes. So she's at the point where she's doing what she likes, not what is expected of her because of the title that she holds at work. So guys, like... Also, the other thing that I learned and I took out of that conversation is the parenting, that as a parent, you need to know that you can't parent your kids the same way. Some have different qualities that are other from the other ones. So you need to be an intentional mother. Above all, as a parent, you need to insert prayer. You cannot parent on your own without God. So like, guys, it's a lot. Like, I don't even want to waste this conversation, but that's what I took out of that conversation: parenting and also being in your own lane.
It is critical that when you want to make a drastic change, you immediately start the day you think about it. If I've managed to lose that much, there's nothing else in life that can be hard for me. When I was growing up, I was dark. I had long hair that was very hard, I was dark in complexion, my teeth are off-white, I was called an ugly kid. So I usually tell young people when they come into the system that, look, as a trainee, you get paid to learn. So never ever miss that opportunity.
The other second last conversation I had, it was with Tadiwa Christmas. I think the second man in the conversation, guys, if I invite you, male guest, please come. We short of you. We want men to inspire. Remember, this podcast, this channel is to inspire my kids, and my kids are boys. So can we please, men, accept my request when I invite you, and let's have more men. I'm not complaining about the women, because I know women are always on the forefront, but men, we need your voice. We need to hear your experience. So Tadiwa came, and what a man. Like, I've always heard that he failed the course and he made his life turn around. And when I was asking him about that, you could see that he's not even faced about that. He's living his purpose. Like, he accepted it. So I want you, as a person or as a young person out there, to go watch that video so that you can learn that you can do mistakes, you can fail over and over, but at some point you're gonna get it right. And it is also important to do things that are in line with your purpose, the things that are in line with your passion, and you shall excel in those places. So young people, please go watch that video and be inspired and learn and get lessons which are gonna change your life forever.
I wanted to do medicine.
Oh, yeah.
And I had applied for radiology and the different courses in the medical field. And unfortunately, my dad passed away that December in my matric year.
Sorry.
But I believe that everything happens for a reason, because that was now able to build me to say, look, there is more things out there beyond school.
Yeah.
During the pandemic, seeing how we're struggling to make ends meet, you know, no one was working at the time. And I thought to myself, you know, there has to be more to this. That's when the Be Wise Magents came into play. So it started during the pandemic to say, I've got data, I've got a platform on Instagram, why am I not sending a message out there to try and motivate?
The last conversation that I had, guys, what a powerhouse. Yo, what a way to close the season. Like, I was having a conversation with Mom Tabisile Ranabe. Guys, yo, I don't know where to even start. But then, guys, what I took out of that conversation, because I have to tell you what I took for myself, is that she started as a teacher. Now she's a businesswoman. To me, it says, sky's the limit. Nothing can limit you. Only you can limit yourself. So she started as a teacher, working. She was a go-getter. She says in her climbing the ladder, she said she requested to write exams, a test, in order to be sent to a university to further her studies. So most of us at the workplace, we instead of asking, we would rather be like, yeah, they always take these ones to go. But sometimes you go and ask, why am I not being included in this? Sometimes go, make the first step and see how your life can turn around. So doing that, she started studying in different universities and going back to work. So what I learned from her is that she was a go-getter. She was a curious person, of which that landed her in the place that she is today. So, guys, she also has an NGO where she gives students or matriculants, if you pass matric and then you have to go to university, she awards you a bursary of 10,000. The best matriculant in Emalahleni will get that 10,000 to go as a startup, so that you can buy your clothes, nyana, your bedding, your soap, everything, like all those necessities that sometimes we know we're coming from different backgrounds, poor background, disadvantaged background. Sometimes it's even hard to get a flight to Cape Town or transport money to a university that you want to go to. So guys, please, please, please watch that video. It's very, very inspirational.
So young people must know how to put money together. Young people must stop thinking that when I put money together, I must be seen to be better than that one. I must seem to be better than that. I must be well-dressed. I must have a beautiful hairstyle. I must have a beautiful makeup. It shouldn't be about you alone. See if you can put things together as a team for you to be in the destination that you want to be in. But the minds must be. And young people, stop putting together stock fells for Christmas. Stop doing that. It is not taking you anywhere. If you decide you want to be in stock fells, be in stock fells for serious business. Don't be in stock fells because you ufuna matsoho magushona. Being created by small businesses. We spoke a lot about the economy growing because of small businesses. And I'm sure you would also notice even now that as much as government employs, but a lot of businesses that we see these days are businesses that are coming from small businesses.
Is it not male dominated?
It is, but what's the difference between us and men?
I love you.
I don't think there's any. When we go to the meeting, we go to the same meeting with them. When we contribute, sometimes we contribute more than them. So what you do, you make sure that you put a salary for yourself. Just like the employees are getting paid, you also get paid.
In these 4 months, in this conversation that I've had with these people, I have grown as a person. I have grown in how I ask questions, my confidence, because I remember the first video that I shoot. I was shaky. I didn't feel good about it, but look at where we are now. I'm more comfortable and not yet there, but I can see where we're going and I'm growing as a person. And there's a lot of great things that are coming in the next season. Guys, look out for the new season. It's coming. But first, guys, can we appreciate Bethany Media? Can we appreciate Themba, guys? Yo, I don't know. If you want to take pictures, you want to take videos, Themba is your guy. You know, I'm not saying this because he's in the room. I'm saying it, and even people that ask me where he's not here, I tell them that he gives his all. He's passionate about this thing. Like now, it's 6 o'clock on a Friday. He could be doing something with his wife, with his kids. But here we are. We are shooting. It says a lot. He had a rough week. We all had a rough week. But he still shows up. And if things are not right, if the conversation was not giving and it was not influential or inspiring, he tells me, he's a team member that I didn't know I needed all this time. Like, I can trust him with everything. And he will deliver. He edits the videos. He takes pics. Like, everything, guys. Please, please, you will never regret using his services. If you want to podcast, he's your man. If you're in Witbank and you want to podcast, he's here. You want to take a video. I'm sure he takes even party videos and all that. Invite him. You will not regret it. So this is me saying to Themba, thank you so much for your continued support and for working with me and for being that voice of reason sometimes and supporting Jay. And when things are not right, if things are not said, well, if things are, the videos are, you say it, and with the most compassionate way. Thank you so much, guys. I cannot stop talking about my media people. So guys, let's watch all the videos, see how he has been doing, see how I've been doing, how I've grown, how we've grown from guest to guest. So thank you so much for watching this video, and thank you so much for watching all the other videos. Let's meet again in June when we introduce new season. We're still doing the same thing. We're still talking to people. We're still getting inspirational stories. But guys, now the levels are up. Like, we are here. If we're here, now we're here. So guys, tune in, invite your friends to like, to subscribe, and hit that notification bell, because when I post, so that you know, you don't have to wait for my update that, oh guys, I have posted. Just hit the notification bell. You will see what's coming. Hey guys, you will see what is coming. Please stay tuned. And you will not regret staying in this family. And I love you. I love you. I love you so much, guys. Thank you. And until next time, thank you. Bye.